Hi, my name is Monika, and I am a content manager at Oxylabs. Today, I will introduce you to pagination and guide you through scraping websites using it. I will show you how websites use pagination as well as how to scrape such websites in Python. Mostly, websites contain large sets of data, which are pretty impractical to display on one page. Even if these data sets are small, the page size would be huge if they were all displayed on one page. This would result in a page taking longer to load and consuming much more memory. The solution for this is to display fewer records per page using pagination. If we take web design as an example, a user interface component called a pager is placed at the bottom of the page. The pager contains links and buttons to navigate to the next, last, or any other specific page. The most common pager types are the following: with a next button, without a next button, with an infinite scroll, and with a load more button. Now, let's illustrate what pagination looks like with a simple example. For this, we will open the Books to Scrape website. Scroll down to see the pager. Here is the next button. When you click it, a browser loads the next page. Now that we have pressed it, we can see the next button along with the previous button. When we reach the final page, only the previous button is shown. Note that with each click, the page URL changes. The next step is to inspect the HTML markup of the next link. This could be done by pressing F12 or Ctrl plus Alt plus I, or by right-clicking the next link and selecting Inspect. In the Inspect window, you can see that the next button is an anchor element and we can find the URL of the next page by looking for it. Yet some websites won't have the next button and instead will show page numbers. See the example from gosc.pl. Let's examine the HTML markup for this page. We can see something interesting here. The HTML contains the links to all of the following pages, so it's easy to visit all these pages. The first thing is to get to the first page. Next, we can use Beautiful Soup, a Python library, to extract all these links to other pages. Finally, we can write a for loop that scrapes all these links. We have covered the functionality of Beautiful Soup and web scraping with Python in general in one of our blog posts. Follow the link on our description if you are interested. Now that we have dug deeper into the basics of pagination, it's time to take a look at scraping paginated websites in the Python programming language. We will start with writing a basic web scraper. First, prepare your environment with the required packages. Open the terminal, activate the virtual environment, and execute this command to install requests, Beautiful Soup 4, and LXML. The requests will be used for HTTP requests, the Beautiful Soup 4 will be used for locating the next button in the HTML, and the LXML is the backend for Beautiful Soup 4. Start with writing a simple code that fetches the first page and prints the footer. Note that we are printing the footer so that we can keep track of the page that is being parsed. In a real-world application, you would replace it with a proper logging and tracking solution or forgo having visibility for performance reasons. The output of this code will be simply the footer of the first page. It's also worth noting that request library is sending a GET request to the specified URL. The SOUP object is being queried using CSS selector. This CSS selector is website specific. Now, let's modify this code to locate the next button. If the next page element is found, we can get the value of the href attribute, which holds the URL of the next page. One important thing to keep in mind here is that often the href will be a relative URL. In such cases, one can use the URL join method from the URL lib parse model to make the URL into an absolute one. By wrapping the code that scrapes a single page with a while loop and the termination condition lacks any more pages, we can reach all pages linked to by the pager. We also have this Python web scraping video tutorial, so press the link in the description if you want to dig deeper. Summing up, in this video, we explored some examples of pagination in web scraping. As we have seen, there are various options for websites to display pagination. To better understand how it works, it's essential to consider the HTML markup and network traffic using developer tools. I hope this video has helped you to grasp pagination and how it works in web scraping. If you have any questions about web scraping or any other specific topic, drop us a line at hello@oxylabs.io or write a comment below. Also, if you find this content beneficial, press the like button and share it on social media. Thanks for watching and see you in other videos!